Alright, everyone. More Shining Force 3 Scenario 2. Right, and out here we are just waiting for the tomb raiding to wrap up. And we will be in good in good shape at least to take on the Sharon. Even if I did waste a whole lot of MP out of Judo's MP pool there to some of the Hell Dragon. Because it's so much fun. Oh, hello, Crystal Rock. I am all over that one. What if I put you in those? I actually seem to enjoy that. Okay. I'll just camp here. Okay. That was a fascinating first strike. I will say no more. Well, that happened. Very bad little luck, though. Alright, I did tell myself I was going to put my cell phone somewhere else. Instead of where I used to keep it. There. A little less noisy now. Yeah. Synthesis, you can just leave again. Sorry. What if I do this to you? Then I will have to drop something. Oh shit. Ah, well, it's worth it. One, for sure. And, yeah. Let's tame our first creature. Not that the Bloodborne is going to be much use, but hey. This is a thing we can do. There we go. Battle calls me quickly to battle. Add Bloodborne to the force. Yes. So, I mean, it would be a bit more exciting if we would actually have caught a dragon. But, you know. Thank you. those guys are still stationary. That is the best we can hope for at the moment. What have we here? That's zero. You can just leave. Synthesis. Oh, wait, no, that would be very wasteful. Yeah, take that, boyo. Yeah. So that's it then. You didn't bring anything. You brought a running ring. I wonder who gave that to. You can give your crystal rod over to synthesis. First thing. Oh, could we? Yeah, we can have some fun with that. And you have nothing, and you have a dark cube. Okay. Right, let's see if we can trigger something. Whew. So far, so good. Yeah, you really don't want to get in a situation where you are hammered on all sides by all these things. Well, I don't think we need to give that. Well, actually we could give that to Pappets for now at least. Huh. It can be fast. Well, he's just going to have to be fast. Inch carefully closer to the formation. I'll just keep David and Medion close together for the friendship boost. And Zero, I will keep away from the currently right-hand side of the battle area. Oh! Yeah! Oh! Okay, 35 attack and Tiamat! Oh, it's on! Yeah, I like Tiamat. I've been biased that way since I first played Scenario 1 in like 98 or 99, whenever that was. I mean, it's just one of those ultimate summons, right? I mean, not that there aren't any better summons in Scenario 2, but it is an ultimate summon. Those are always a little cooler. Well, they are starting to think. Let's see, no. Let's not give the Hell Sniper an easy target, actually. I will put him down there. Okay, we are going to be blasted by something now. We weren't? What is this nonsense? Habit is just crazy fast. Well, let's just do this thing. Standing still, that's just the way we want it. Oh boy. No. Nope. No, 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 no. You cast him in level 3 instead of healing your buddy. They're going to be remembering that on the next on the next staff meeting, you know? Good funerals can take a few of these. Have a little fun with this here spell. Doesn't make a whole lot of difference. Oh well. Are you guys seeing this? 40-something damage. What? Huh. Well, I mean, what can I say? That happened. Manners. Well, this was spread out over a few people, so that should be okay. Oh, wow. Well, 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 well. We're just gonna have to go ham right now. You go. You have aura. You should use it. Come here. should just run for the hills. Okay, I'll take Kenta over there. That'll put her a little too close to the Minotaur. But we are kind of in a sticky spot at this moment in time. Puppets. Which is one very creative way to misspell puppet, I have to say. Oh wait, axes are stronger than glasses. Fantastic. Okay, Jade is going to be murdered massively on the next turn. Be best to get started on him, actually. I didn't get a whole lot of bang for that buck, though. Bye, Jade. Yeah, I don't see Jade surviving this. Notice how quickly everything just turned pear-shaped there, right? I mean, for all that I'm getting murdered, something spectacular it is. This is really stupid, you know? Never try this at home. You're going to do need to sell your firstborn to the RNG goddess after this. Let's see. I'll put you there. Help out with the Minotaur. Maybe the Puppets can come and smack him on the nose, and something will get better. Possibly. Okay, let's see by how much Zero is murdered the next turn. Resist, resist. Or not. Very well. Okay, if Hasuki doesn't kill Minotaur now, Puppets should be able to recruit him. Let's say best case scenario. Never mind. No! Haha! This might actually work. Okay. Puppy thingy. You need 59 attack. And you have 67. Oh yes! I am going to recruit myself a Minotaur. Now, do you want some heavenly range attacks? Say yes, please. Open wide. Huh. Well, okay. Critical hit to the abs. Bad. She might have survived that at 4 HP. It is a very real possibility that she could have. Damn. Okay, Pappets, do your thing. An exclamation point. Okay. I didn't have to sacrifice Hasuki on that. Yes. Haha. This is great. Doing so good. What's this? Arthur actually dealing damage? Maybe I should stay behind here and do this. Oh, come on, y'all. Destroyed him very well. So now we have that Hell Sniper to worry about, and of course the Sharon. David should stay to spread out the damage. Not liking the presence of that Hell Sniper. But there's only so much I can do about that. Okay. Ah, Synthesis. You can do this. Well, won't hurt a lot, but it's a thing we can do. Scratch that, 26 is a good deal of damage. heal thyself. Sharon. Too close. Too close. We ain't liking that. No, sir. Not having that. Thanatos to the face. To David and do this. Get a little friendship boost going? Yes, I can. Puppets, can we do anything worthwhile here? Maybe. Maybe not. Okay, so the sharing encounter. Now I know. For Hedva and not the Birdman? Well, I guess that's a sound tactical decision. I don't have anyone who needs healing, do we? Nope. Not a blessed soul. I have a double palm to the nose. Close. Although I'll leave him for zero, I think. Said and done. Leveling up. Yeah, I don't think this is gonna hurt too much. Yeah, you only beat her within an inch of her life. Only just not use teammates. Right, have some of this yourself then. Okay, the Shuriken was a lot. Well, was greatly resistant to that. Clear that space for symbios. Let's see. Well, her MP is nearly done, so that's good. And here comes Arthur, like he means it. No, maybe you should heal Synthesis. This be the end of the fight. It just might. I didn't mean for that to rhyme, but yeah, science at the time. Oh, 2 defense. That's always helpful. Go. I've lost. The invincible High Priestess Desharon has been defeated by the lowly army of Prince Medea. Oh, bugger. That thing's moving. Oh no, a tank. Passage out of the ruins must be open. We're too late. At least I kept my promise to guard. Haha. It's not time for your life to end yet. Sister? You're new. How are you to share a sister without any purple hair? Who are you? Ballsome sect, we won't give this to you. Please do not hinder me. I do not want to hurt anyone. I've heard something like that from Ballsome buggers before, and it's never ended well. Why should I believe you? I am from the north, but I am not part of the Balsam sect. Are you sure the Balsam sect thinks of you the same way? Not part of the Balsam sect, but the power you displayed appears to be dark power. Please don't say that. Your aura feels just like the Vandal Gong. Oh? No? So, there are lady vandals? No! No! Don't upset her. Jane is a good person. Please don't cry, Jane. It'll be alright. What? This is taking a turn for the weird. Sister. My sister, Desharon. Well, I mean, If Jean knows the Sharon is here, she should have some awareness of her plans. And if she has the same kind of powers that Golem has, she should be a Vandal, according to the typical video game logic. Although Golem is, well, he's not a clear-cut creature. Which I guess we should leave it at that for now. I mean, it doesn't really make a lot of sense to hear this from someone in her position. Although I don't actually think she is a bad character as such. Well, anyway, we'll leave that for Shinigami. You won the battle, isn't that enough? Please allow us to leave quietly. Should we let them go, Prince Medion? I don't think we have a lot of say in the matter. A wise decision, Prince. Our priority is the ancient tank. Well, and there's that, I guess. So, you will let us go. Thank you. Sister Desharon, you'll feel better soon. Just hold on. Let's see, what a mysterious girl. She possesses formidable powers. I can sympathize with her. Such a troubled girl. What do you mean? I saw a deep sorrow in her eyes. She appears to be suffering a fate from which she can't escape. She's being coerced, then. Now it's not the time to get sentimental, Synthesis. I don't actually remember what the catch would have been, though. We have an important task at hand. Yeah. Garvin and the Juggernaut. Oh hey, look at that. There's a highlight from Mag's playthrough of Fire Emblem Radiant Dawn, from which I got the idea of the shiny scrubs. out now on a YouTube machine near you. Garvin and the Juggernaut, blah blah blah. The ancient tank is on the move, and Aspia is in grave danger. By Elvis, we must stop it. You mean we're going to try to stop it? How do you stop something so huge? You rip out the battery, cut a hole in the fuel line, stick a thermal detonator up its tailpipe. Oh wait, that's a different universe. Brilliant idea just came to me. Brilliant idea? What is it? In order for it to succeed, we will need the cooperation of the entire Medion army. Let's return to headquarters and discuss our strategy. Oh, is this going to be a long cutscene? Almost finished. Such vision! Ratak can devise ingenious strategies like no other, and at his age. Yes. Then let us discuss this Juggernaut. It's a weapon that was designed to advance on its enemies. You mean it's a vehicle? I mean, obviously it is a vehicle. But isn't there like something more to it? If it's a weapon? Just saying. If we attack it from the front, he will be at a disadvantage, since its defense is strong. One thing is for sure, we must disarm the tank's primary weapon. What are your thoughts, Campbell? It is not likely we could destroy it by attacking it head on. We're in agreement. We will not attempt a frontal attack. It could be disabled from the inside, but where's the access and how will we get inside without being seen? The side of the tank. Ratak, the side is accessible and there appears to be a blind spot. We should be able to board it. No way! One of Garvin's soldiers entered the tank just before that last battle. He used steps on the side of the tank. We can use those steps to get inside the tank. Did I say that before? If so, the tank can be stopped from the inside. There will be many enemies surrounding the tank. We'll never get inside with a direct attack. You're right, David. We will need to distract the enemies around the tank. Distract them? How will we distract them? With an elite force led by Prince Milion. But we expect there to be two battalions moving with the tank. If both battalions attack at once, Milion's force could be in trouble. We don't have much choice. We'll place the majority of our army in the Milion force since Garvin's forces are concentrated in the front. This is certainly a dangerous and risky strategy. However, it is a good one. You agree, Prince? I'm going to have to agree. To make yourself a target, you are very brave, Prince Milion. We have heard the prince's opinion. How does everyone else feel about this? It's not like we need to worry. The prince can handle any situation. I'm part of the Median army, and I will do as he asks. And anyway, I think it's crazy exciting. okay. The lady is gung-ho in Shining Force 3. We must execute our plan to perfection. Timing is critical. The tank must be disabled before it reaches Aspion. Everyone believes in you, Prince Milion. Give us your orders, whatever they may be. An excellent strategy for attack. If we are to stop Garvin, we must look at every detail. Dun dun dun. Hello, Poppy. That last battle in the ruins, Emperor Domeric was concerned about the Median army and wanted to pay a visit to your headquarters. We had to let Garvin go even though we had the upper hand. I wanted to pursue Garvin. Emperor, Median is not to blame for Garvin's escape. Don't misunderstand, I'm not blaming Median. I am to blame for Garvin's escape from the ruins. I should have come earlier. So the tank has left the ruins. We won't rest until it is stopped, so we offer our support. The Median army is fortunate to have strategists such as yourself, Grantak. Your experience is invaluable in dealing with this juggernaut. I have a bit of experience forming battle strategies myself. Then, what do you think of my plan for disabling the tank? It's a solid idea. Maybe Emperor Domeric has some thoughts to add. The elite of the Median force may be wondering if they will be used most effectively as a decoy. The answer lies in the enemy's probable reinforcement strategy. If their forward battalion needs reinforcements, it will take priority. This will leave those securing the inside of the tank with no reinforcements. Leon, it appears you take after your mother. Such grace and commitment to perfection. That was an interesting sprite animation. Prince Medion, you will lead the frontal battalion in this strategy. David, can you lead the second battalion inside the tank? The mission will be difficult and dangerous, but I believe we can succeed if I have everyone's support. In the Elven Forest, David was the Elf's leader. He's the perfect leader for this mission. Our lives are in your hands, David. Be strong. May Elvis's grace be with me. Aspia's safety depends on us. We must stop the Juggernaut. And that is it, ladies and gentlemen. The next story fight is the last battle. Before that, I'm going to level up a couple of characters in Heroes Test, bring everyone up to a more even level. Also, we are kind of going to be needing levels like effing crazy. We're going to be selling stuff too, right? All off screen like. And maybe try for a few more Mithril weapons. And with all that out of the way, I will see you next time. I'm going to be doing the Heroes Test mostly off screen. So the next time you see me will be maybe my third or fourth attempt at the Heroes Test, where I should be able to get a good part of the way into the dungeon itself. Let's see. So level 13. Oh, right! David swapped for Penko automatically. Hedva and Zero are the same level. What is this nonsense? Well, yeah. The thing is, David's group there, you do not want it to look like this. You want to put your strongest characters in the reserves if you can't help it. Not to the point that you cripple Medion's group, of course, but only four members is just too little. And with that said, yeah, goodbye for now, and see you back with a couple of levels more under my belt. Until next time.